Hello, can you hear me now? Can you hear me?
Yes, perfect.
Okay. So sorry for
Don't
this.
worry, it's happened. So, can you go ahead?
Yes. Okay, so good morning and sorry for this issue. Today I'm gonna talk about this work titled A Sensor Network Based on IoT and its Source to Analyze the Catch Basin Environment in the Context of the Aedes albopictus Expansion in Switzerland. Of course, the protagonist, the main character of this work is the albopictus because of its continued expansion and combined to its ability to transmit herbal virus. Is raising major public health concern in Switzerland as well in Europe. The mosquito was introduced in Italy in 1990, and in almost 5 years, it was present in all Italy. For this reason, in Canton Ticino, Ticino, Switzerland, in 2000 was established the first working group for the surveillance and control of the mosquitoes. And around 2007, it was present in some urban areas. In 2017, this working group collects more or less 10,000 samples. And I can say that this mosquito was present also in the Canton Ticino. But for the regions in the north of the Alp, around the 2018, the mosquito is still not present. But of course, the mosquito can go there, can reach the north of the Alps, exploiting the traffic crossing the country. But according to some prediction based on a large-scale model, Zurich and Basel seems to have two cold winter seasons for the survival of the eggs. In fact, the mosquito is highly influenced by environmental parameters such as temperature and rain patterns. This means that when the temperature is around minus 10 degrees, basically the eggs can't survive. For this reason, there is a need of monitoring, but we have also to be aware that in city there are other effects. There are urban heat island effects, but also some other microclimates where the mosquito can survive. And so there is a need of monitoring this kind of environment. And that's why there is the ALBIS project, which the main aim is to monitor this environment. This is a project of about 2 years. The first year was funded by SUPSI, and the second by the Swiss Federal Office for the Environment. And this project, starting from the material and methods, this project needs to install some sensor. And this sensor needs have some requirements, such as lower power consumption, long-range data transmission, low costs, and also an adequate data quality. That means that we don't want to have such as 0.001 accuracy of temperature, but still a good quality of data. And the idea is to put this sensor inside the catch basin, some other sensor outside, and basically this sensor wireless can transmit the data through the web. Of course, either for the hardware and software, we chose to go for the open source approach. In this slide, I would like to show you what is the prototype that we produced. The prototype has a cost of around 100 euro. It can measure humidity, pressure, light intensity, and wall and water temperature. This sensor, as I said, is basically put inside catch basin, but also in some places outside. The idea is to use the LoRa technology to transmit data to a Swisscom gateway, And then the information was bounced to the ISOS instance on the service and make the data available for data analysis and other things. One of the main goals of the project was the deployment of the sensor. During the first year, we deployed 20 sensors in Lugano, where the mosquito is already present. Then other 20 in Lausanne, another 20 in Zurich and Basel, always in the main cities and in some other parks around the cities. When the data were collected, we did some data analysis, starting from in terms of data completeness. So we analyzed how many data we collect and what we expected. We analyzed data in terms of data quality. So we perform a range test, a step test, and a minimum variability test. The first test look if observation is inside a range that is set. Then the step test test if the observation with the previous one and with the next one to see if there is a variability that is acceptable. And the minimum variability test is like to see if a value is the same for a lot of time. That means that there is maybe an error in the sensor or in the data collection procedure. Then we also be able to map the LoRa signal thanks to the data collected from the Swisscom infrastructure. And we perform a comparison between internal and external sensors to see if there are some differences in temperatures, but also between sensors installed thanks to the project and the MeteoSwiss station, the nearest MeteoSwiss station, to understand if these sensors are okay to be installed, or maybe it's enough to have a MeteoSwiss station to get data from there. And then the last analysis that we perform is about the cold events, basically periods under a fixed temperature limit. And here are the results. There are four maps. Here there are just two about Lausanne and Lugano. And here you can see that the LoRa technology is working quite good in these cities. I would like to remember that these are sensors put underground inside catch basin, which is a harsh environment for data transmission. But in these cities, the communication was quite good. Also, the signal, the SNR is over zero enough. So we didn't get so many troubles in these cities. In Zurich and Basel, the situation is different because the LoRa technology is working okay, but we collected data with a worse signal. So here the communication, even are in the main city, is still affected by some interferences. And here I would like to show you the results about data quality. As I said, we collect the data about internal pressure, light, internal temperature and battery. And here there is the test about the 101 test, that is the range test, then 103, that is the step test, and then 104, that is the minimum variability test. And you can see that for all the parameters, more or less, we have a good quality of data. Of course, for light and battery, we didn't test this observation for the minimum variability test, which is the 104, because you know that during night, the lux is always zero, so it doesn't make any sense to test this parameter with such a test. And here there are the other graphs about wall temperature, water temperature, and air humidity. And you can see that also here we have a good quality of data. but we have some troubles for the test 104. For example, humidity, we have only the 66% of the data with a good quality. But that's because since the sensor is inside catch basin, sometimes happens that the water goes inside, and so the humidity rises till 100% constantly. And for the water temperature, you know that measuring the water temperature in winter, it means that there are very few variations in the temperature on the in the water, especially in winter. So that's why we have not so many observations that passed this test. And here are the results about data completeness for four cities: Losanna, Lugano, Zurich, Basilea. And here you can see that the completeness is very high, so we are quite satisfied with this network. Only two sensors, the AL50 and 51, has a data completeness around 70%, so we just need to move this sensor in maybe in another areas. And here are the results about the call event analysis. The threshold is set to 0 degree. And you can see that there are not so many sensors with a temperature below zero for enough time. There are only two cases, maybe the AL008, which is in Lugano, where we get 3 days where the temperature was continuously under zero, and also the AL055, which is in Zurich. It's quite interesting because we measure 5 days where the temperature was continuously below zero. That's because this sensor in particular was isolated, so there is a low underground infrastructure, there is no defect of the heat island. But looking to a different analysis where we put the threshold at minus one, you can see that the sensors are very few. There is still the sensor in Zurich that is measuring temperature so low, but in the other areas that does not happen. And the things is that Lugano seems to have colder catch basin than Zurich and Basel, and that's probably is not a problem of measuring, but it's real because in Zurich and Basel there is a great underground infrastructure, so that can affect the temperature of the catch basins. And here there are the comparisons. We compare data for the with the external sensor with the internal one, and you can see that there are differences as expected. The mean temperature difference is 2 degrees, and that is quite important when there are low temperature. Here another example where there are even more differences from the outside to the inside. And also you can see that the inside temperature has less variations compared to the one outside. So this temperature is more constant. And here we try to correlate the data with the meteorology station, and what we saw is that if we correlate data between meteorology station, the sensor that we put outside, there is a good correlation. So the sensor that we put outside maybe is not so important. But in the meantime, there is not a good correlation between the Meteo Suisse and the sensor that we put inside the catch basin. So I go through this slide because I have not more time because of me. and go to the conclusions. And I can say that the open source approach permits to build a cost-effective solution to monitor catch basin, enforce with cities and manage the data collected. Sensors, the sensor prototype, which are open hardware, open software, provide good quality of data and reliability. And the data analysis showed that catch basins have a microclimate which is prone to help the mosquitoes ex-deposing. Thank you for the attention.
Daniel, thank you so much for your presentation. It's been really interesting for all of us. We have a lot of questions. So we can start with the question, and if we can finish, then the people can reach out to you through Venules or something else. So the first question is, do you spatially interpolate the record of the sensors?
You mean the data collected from the sensors?
Yes.
No, we didn't do that. But it's something that we would like to do maybe in future. But the thing is that maybe we have so less 20 sensors per city is not enough to get a good quality of data, you know, when you interpolate. But it's something to do also because it's interesting to see how the temperature, the variation, the spatial variation of the temperature in the cities because of the, you know, underground infrastructure, because maybe can affect that, as I said before. But we didn't do that.
Perfect. Thank you. The next one, do you also monitor the mosquito population with ovid traps, for example, to assess their activity?
Yes, we did the other colleagues did also such kind of measurements, and basically we tried to cover all the catch basin where there are the ovid traps, but of course we put more sensor than ovid traps.
Perfect, thank you. The next one, do you have an estimate of the quality of interpolations?
No,
because you say that. Okay, I am reading all the questions that the people.
Yeah, yes.
Then the other one, which method you use for the spatial interpolation is the same for the other one. Do you compare the interpolation to the LST or other interpolator air temperature data? It's the same because
I think that maybe that question is about this interpolation, because I have interpolated the data about the LoRa signal. Okay. So for this kind of interpolation, I use the GRASS module, the spline, a spline method using the GRASS module. So, but for this time, I use it through QGIS. Okay, because I saw that it's working okay, but some years ago I remember that didn't work so well, so I always use directly GRASS. But in this case, I use a spline interpolator thanks to GRASS.
Perfect. We have another one. The sensor had been made with Arduino.
No, we used the LoPy from PyCom company. Why we chose this microcontroller? Because it has LoRa integrated. It has a LoRa module integrated, and also because we can program it with MicroPython, which. We did sensor with Arduino, but you know, we would like also to try how is to program a microcontroller with Python, and it was quite a good experience because it's very easy to make it working.
Perfect. Thank you so much. And the last one, is there a GitHub or GitLab where to find this project?
Yes, we have a GitLab repo, but it's still private since the project is not still ended.
Oh, perfect. So do you know when it will be public? Or
yes, maybe in one year, more or less.
Perfect. So, Daniel, thank you so much for your presentation, for your time. I'm sorry for the first 5 years or
sorry
minute, but don't worry, that happens. Thank you so much for all the audience. We are finishing this session, the morning session, and now we can go to the central, the Malena Liefman at 11 a.m. from Argentina. Okay, thank you so much for all the audience, and Daniel, thank you again.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye.